Jake here with Venter Visuals, and today I'm hyped to be showing you guys a little breakdown of the Pixel Sorter plugin and how I use it in some of my music videos. I'll include a link to this plugin below. It's one of my favorite plugins in After Effects. It's not that expensive, so I highly recommend checking it out if you shoot or edit music videos. I'm pretty sure that this effect is also very popular within like the gaming editing community. It's just a very creative plugin, and we're gonna be breaking down two ways to use it. One as just kind of an effect, in the second way as more of a transition. So let's get into it. So we have two clips here. This first clip is him sitting on the ledge. The second clip is him wearing his red jacket in a cool spot. If you watch my example right here, which is actually what it looks like in the actual music video that we shot. So we're gonna create this effect by using the Pixel Sorter plugin. You can also notice that during all of this, it's a reverse of this clip that's before it. It's just reversed and then goes a little bit faster, and then it cuts into the next clip with a little flash transition. So we'll kind of break down this whole sequence. So the first thing I want to do is the reversal effect. So let's listen for the beat and decide how long we want this reverse effect to last. So right there probably is when the reverse starts. So we're just gonna delete the rest of this. So it's just, so we got that little like right there. That's gonna be where the reverse happens. So now what we're gonna do is hold Alt Option, drag this first clip up. We're gonna hit Command R. We're gonna reverse the speed. We're gonna turn the speed up to like 300, and we're gonna drag this all the way to the end over here. We're just gonna cut it a little bit at the beginning, so it kind of jumps a little bit from that to this right there. Perfect. We're gonna go ahead and drag the rest of that in. So now we got this, right? So, all right, so now that we got our clip set in the timeline and adjusted to how we want it, we're gonna right click on it, we're gonna go ahead and hit nest, and then we're gonna right click on it again and hit replace with After Effects composition. That's just gonna bring it right into After Effects here. And what I'm gonna do now is just throw on the AE Pixel Sorter, which you'll find over here in your effects and presets tab once you download it. Over here, I can start changing some of these values. So at the very beginning, I don't want any pixel sorting to happen. So I'm just gonna make a keyframe here at that first frame and turn the threshold to a 1. So there's no pixel sorting happening yet. So it's gonna gradually happen throughout this scene. So here towards the end, I'm gonna scroll over here. I'm gonna change the threshold, and we're gonna start going down and start customizing our look here, right? So you can see what it's doing to the background, right? And you can customize this. Now we're only affecting the highlights. So you can see here at the top, it says effect, right? So we're only affecting the brighter parts of this image. Now we can change it to shadows, and guess what? It's gonna affect the shadowy parts of the image. Pretty cool, pretty customizable for this. I think it looks good with the highlights. I think this is kind of a trippy look right here with the background, and kind of like it's not getting him so much as it is kind of the background. You know, we made a keyframe here at the end with this new threshold. So if I open this up, drop down my effects, look at my AE Pixel Sorter, you can see got a keyframe here, got a keyframe over here. If I open it up and I open up the process, you can see the threshold keyframes, and you can tweak these out even more if you want to. So from here, what I'm gonna do is just hit Command S, and that's gonna save it back into Premiere Pro. And now as I scroll through Premiere Pro, you can see we get that effect happening, right? Now there is one other effect that kind of goes into this sequence right here, and that is this bright flash that's happening right here. And all you need to do is apply a luma corrector, adjust the gamma, the gain, and the pedestal, and make some keyframes. I have done a couple other videos about flash transitions that you can find on my channel if that's interesting to you and you want to learn more about it. All this flash is doing is just adding to that kind of sequence. So again, we have, you know, the first part, then the reverse, the pixel sorting, and then the flash, right? So it's a pretty quick sequence right there. Now I do wanna show you guys one more way you can use pixel sorting. So I'm just gonna drag both those clips over here just for this example. So we're just gonna go ahead and start at this cut. We're gonna hold shift, go 1 to the left, click that, hold shift, go 2 to the right, click that. So we have 10 frames here. I'm gonna right click on both of them, and we're just gonna turn these into a nested sequence. Just right click on that, replace with After Effects composition, and now we can kind of tweak this transition. So you can see it's all one layer here. So now what we're gonna do is just drag our pixel sorter back on. We're gonna start it pretty low. So we're gonna start it at 1, right at the beginning, and that's gonna give us 0 pixel sorting. And then kind of right here in the middle, we want it to be a lot of pixel sorting. So you can see right there, we're getting a lot of pixel sorting going on. That's gonna be a keyframe. That's gonna make a keyframe here in the middle. And then towards the end, we're gonna go back to one because we don't want it happening anymore. So now we're getting like this, you know, pixelated transition. Now, one thing I noticed is that this scene is pretty dark. So if we change it to shadows, you can see how much more dramatic it is on that scene versus the other one. Now, if we're targeting the shadows, what we need to do is come to our effects, our pixel sorter, our input, our process, open up the process, and change our threshold instead from one, start it at zero, go up to one here in the middle, and then come back down to zero here at the end, right? So we're just flipping the values, right? So now we get this, which actually looks a lot better this way. So if that's what you have to do is change it from highlights to shadows, remember just to change your threshold numbers around. Now what I'm gonna do is just hit Command S, and that's gonna save our little transition back into Premiere Pro. Let's watch it back in full motion. So there it is, pretty dope little transition. I love this effect. Boom, so sick. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button down below. I appreciate everybody who's tuned in and is watching my videos, hitting the subscribe button, commenting down below. I see it all, and I love every one of you who participates on this channel and is a part of this community, which I'm trying to grow more this year. I'm trying to care more about YouTube and posting more content, making really good tutorials, and helping people out there in the world discover new editing tricks and just get better at making visuals. And if you're out there watching and you're not a part of this community yet, make sure to hit that subscribe button. I'm also going to be dropping some really dope packs this year for video editors. Now, I do already have some really cool stuff on my website, venturevisuals.com, stuff like transitions, overlays, light leaks, which are all very useful for music video edits, gaming edits, vlogs, YouTube videos. So if you're an editor who's looking to add a little sauce to your visuals, definitely check that out. I'll include a link below. And shout out to you for tuning into this video. You rock. I appreciate it. And until next time, I'm Jake Venner. Peace out. Thank you.